Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Blind. Now entering Edgewater. Oh, I have to hold it. Better than nature. Does that say anthocyanin? Facial mask, skin cream, anti-cleos. Got a lot of experience just for getting in here. A corporate guard.
Don't make me report you to Mr. Togson.
Why would you? So yeah, we're finally getting to Edgewater, guys. This is probably not a typical playthrough, as I just went through almost everything, but nice. The guitar, I love it. There's something back there. Don't report me, okay? What you got? Can't stand on that, right? Mm-hmm. Man, it reminds me of Fallout 2 with the slide guitar. That sounds just like from the Stand miniseries. A compass. This compass can be used to locate magnetic north on any world with a strong magnetic field, i.e. any planet with a ferrodynamic core. Not for use on gas giants or in deep space. I wouldn't think so. 10 bits and a hunting rifle. Well, it's getting morning time here. That's not somewhere I can go into. Alright. Well, we are gonna go look around at everything. That can be looked at anyway. Chairman Rockwell and Minister Clark, the team to lead Halcyon to an even better tomorrow. Help the Chairman and Minister Clark defeat our foes. And the other poster at top we've seen.
I'm sorry, I'll just be a minute.
You had a minute. Next one comes out of your pay.
He's off the threats, friend. I'm going.
What's the cannery there?
We all got quotas to make.
Huh?
Move along. Yeah.
Got my sights on you.
You must have eyes in the back of your head. Oh. Door's open. What is this? Looks like a church.
Our place in the universe is fixed.
I didn't know it was broken before.
Carry on.
Mm-hmm.
Our place in the universe is fixed.
I've been hearing that. It doesn't look like it's a steal, right? Look, We've got the lament configuration. That's how you get Pinhead. We don't want Pinhead. Then our place won't be fixed anymore. Oh, okay. Junk. Oh, it's a oh, this is junk? Oh, this is so something you can use. Well, kind of figures we have all this. What do we need an old time compass for, right? It's already built into our suit. I thought it was something that was going to be added to the HUD or something like that. But nope. Quests. It's a quest. Tastes like enlightenment. This might look nice in one of the cruise rooms on the Unreliable. Okay. I guess someone's gonna want that.
Hey there, Mary. Don't see you round here too often.
Oh, I just came to talk to the vicar is all. None of us are above confessionals.
What have you got to confess? You ain't thinking of deserting, are you?
What? No. And I resent the accusation.
Wasn't nothing but a question. Do excuse me.
Doesn't sound like she resents it.
I must be on my way. Verity to you. Work fortifies the spirit.
She sounded very cheerful about how she resented the implication.
Work fortifies the spirit.
Okay, you guys are a bunch of zombies.
Talking to the good vicar always lifts up my spirits.
I've just been here, right? Alright. It's here I haven't been in. Alright. Hi.
Yes, what is it? You're an outsider. Fantastic.
No kidding.
Vicar Maximilian de Soto at your service. Or Vicar Max if you're the sort who prefers brevity. I so rarely get new people to talk to. Name your poison, anything at all. Spiritual counseling, this season's tossball predictions, the quickest way out of town.
How'd you know I'm an outsider?
I've never seen you before, and there's been no paperwork indicating a transfer.
Small town, please.
Half the time it's wrong, but a new worker without paperwork? Unheard of. Also, you lack the distinctive worker gaze. Usually either a deadening behind the eyes, or in some rare cases, a wild-eyed frenzy, like a trapped animal.
You seem quite dismissive of the common man for a spiritual leader.
Oh, nothing could be further from the truth. I'm simply bemoaning the level of spiritual awareness in this town.
Isn't it your job to raise that?
Yes, but there are few who hear me in this miserable place. I must double my efforts to elevate my flock. These are good, hard-working people here.
Hold on a minute. Did you just refer to this town as a miserable place?
Yes, and thank you for pointing it out. It is wrong of me to succumb to distress. This place could be so much more. And I will continue in my quest to make it so.
I'm looking for a power regulator.
Mechanical tomfoolery is well out of my purview. I suggest you take such matters to Mr. Thompson in the cannery. Oh, and a word of warning. If you're considering wandering around outside the safety of the town, you'd best be cautious.
I've been outside. I'm not impressed. I can handle myself better than a vicar.
The marauders I met when I ventured outside the walls might agree with you. Bastards snuck up on me while I was dutifully hunting for a banned book in a collector's library. Barely escaped with my life. But you see, one of the reasons I transferred here was to get my hands on that heretical text. If you managed to acquire it for me, I'd pay quite a handsome sum for the book.
Why would a vicar be after a banned heretical book?
I just want to keep the writing out of layman's hands. Oh. It wouldn't do for such information to fall into public consumption.
I love the music. So like the other description says, he wants to get a hold of it to destroy it. I need to know a little bit more about this book before I agree to this.
It's a handwritten journal. A faded blue cover with the name M. Bakonu handwritten in the lower corner. Hmm. I'll mark where I saw it on your map. Assuming you're serious? It is not only a beautiful relic of a bygone time, it's also the thoughts of an early thinker on the nature of man's place in the cosmos. Not many in this colony could understand its true value. Should they ever read it.
Alright. I'll look for your book. Not necessarily gonna give it to him, but I'll look for it.
Thank you. If you retrieve it, you can always find me here.
The Illustrated Manual. Victor Maximilian de Soto has asked you to find a banned heretical book, The Journey of M. Bakonu. When the collector had to abandon his home, he hid the banned book in a small cave, along with some other contraband, travel to the cave and retrieve it. Max says, the journal was last possessed by a book collector whose residence was part of a small community directly north of Edgewater. He has marked the location on your map. Region. Point of interest, objective. Directly north. So here then? Well, maybe once I get outside, I can look at this stuff easier. This is nothing I have already. I still have to return this volume 1 back to the botanical area.
Any progress on that matter we discussed?
Not yet, I haven't moved.
Please get it.
Seem pretty concerned about that book. Can you tell me why?
A religious text deemed heretical by the OSI is an unsafe object at large. Though I understand why a collector would desire to possess such a rare book.
OSI?
Because I'm also a collector of books. Rare things in this colony. Appreciation of the written word outside monthly periodicals is virtually unknown here.
What sort of spiritual advice do you offer here?
They who are not satisfied with their work are satisfied with nothing. No. How about, work fortifies the spirit. True exhaustion awaits idle hands.
I was actually asking what your religion was all about.
The OSI teaches that the Grand Architect set a perfect system in motion at the beginning of time.
Sorry.
Contentment is found by accepting one's role in that grand plan.
Oh, you guys might be able to see my mouse pointer now. I hope. Shadow Play has fixed an issue with it. What does OSI stand for? Grand Architect. Yeah.
The Order of Scientific Inquiry. Mm-hmm. Also known as Scientism to the layperson.
How do you talk to this grand architect? Prayer? Meditation? Or what?
You don't talk to the grand architect. Once the universe was set in motion, it stepped back. It has no concern for us.
Doesn't sound like a very motivational religious philosophy. What's there to aspire to?
We will eventually decode the plan and all its intricacies. Once we are able to deduce the properties of every particle in the universe and its trajectory, we will know everything. The future, the past, each person's place within the plan, all will be laid out before us, removing struggle and bringing peace. No one will ever need question their path again. Some even believe this ultimate knowledge will unlock mankind's true potential, and we will all become akin to grand architects ourselves, after a fashion.
Mm-hmm. I'm like both of these. Really, how does that work? Tell me more.
Well, first there's the matter of the secret blood rites and animal sacrifices. I'm kidding.
Very funny.
Seriously, though, to truly understand the metaphysics involved takes years of study and contemplation.
I just thought of something else I need to be doing. There's another option. I think I could talk to him.
Any progress on that matter we discussed? Please get it. What would you like to discuss?
Oh no, that's it. Okay. Never mind. Alright. So, Vicar Max, everybody. And the OSI. Is it nighttime again? This thing makes that noise? Let's go this way first. I love it.
You think corporate's ever gonna visit?
I'm not holding out hope.
Somebody's been rambling about some colony ship. Wonder what that's about.
We don't get a lot of visitors.
Okay. General store. And I think I just passed some other place by as well. Hi.
It's not the best choice, it's Spacer's choice. And before you ask, I'm all out of deluxe salt tuna. All I've got is gourmet.
So Spacer's choice is not the best choice? I need to fix a ship. You know where I can find some parts?
You ought to go have a talk with the boss, Reed Thompson. He's up in his tower above the cannery.
Yeah, we already headed there, actually. Got some questions for you.
Go right ahead.
What's your take on this place?
What, you mean Edgewater? That's a peculiar question. This a test? Am I being tested right now?
No.
It's, fine and dandy. Couldn't be happier. Wouldn't want to spend my life working anywhere else. Prettiest little town on Terra 2.
I'm glad you're so optimistic.
I have every reason to be. I caught a real break working in a place like this. I don't get paid for banter. Was there something you needed?
Actually, there was.
Go right ahead.
Anyone I should watch out for here?
Other than yourself? Definitely the vicar. Don't get me wrong. He seems a decent man, cut from church cloth, knows his scriptures. But there's something about him that bothers me. Like he's not one of us. Sometimes I suspect he doesn't even want to be here.
Alright. Well, thanks. Anyone else?
I'd keep a few paces between myself and Miss Holcomb, the town mechanic since her dear father left the workforce.
Holcomb.
No ill intent in her, mind. Just a queer sort, restless, scatterbrained, inclined to do first and think after, if you take my meaning.
Interesting. Is that everyone I should know about?
Amelia. Definitely Amelia Kim. I advise against stepping foot in her drinking establishment altogether. Word is, they're gonna replace her with an auto mechanical barkeep. She's, what's the word? Obsolete. You don't want to associate yourself with that kind of person.
You're kidding me, right? I thought the place was trouble. But she's obsolete, that's why I should not go in there?
Spacer's Choice, the brand of choice for Spacer's... Music to my ears.
Alright. Let's sell some stuff. Oh, I can have him repair stuff. Now, I can't even mouse over this. But I see sell value, weight, and condition is 84%. Repair all equipped. I have a 1% discount. So E is sell, so E is probably also repair. How much money do I have? That's my money? My bits, 2,000. I just want to see something repaired, guys. Ball stick. Did I even ever use that thing? Sell junk. So it's a hunting rifle. Light pistol. Saw that. Sort of shotgun. Condition 5%. And it's so cheap because the condition is really bad. But I'm just going to sell it rather than repair. I'll just use the other one. Hunting rifle. Okay. Cool. It's repaired. Sweet. Or you can just repair the stuff yourself at a workbench. Oh. I guess we get in trouble if we go in there. Let me try to stay out of trouble here. What place is this? Oh, this is the Cantina, okay. As opposed to the Cantuna.
Just gotta keep our heads up. Sorry, I've got a lot to do.
Hey.
Sorry, I got a lot to do.
Ah, you'll talk to me.
Never seen you here before. You a visitor?
Winslow.
Welcome. On behalf of the Spacer's Choice family, let me welcome you to where am I again?
Edgewater.
Edgewater, jewel of the Vale. May the law bless our beloved cannery with 100 years of, what's it called?
Prosperity.
Productivity. That's the one. Yep, that's us. Productive.
I think you've had a little too much to drink.
Oh, it's fine. I'm only on my third bottle. I don't start heaving up my guts as long as I can count to three. Company lets me imbibe as much zero-G brew as I can afford. Even gave me a discount on account of my injury. You jealous yet?
You were injured?
Yep. Got my mitt stuck in a rotor wheel. Shredded my wrist up real good. Conrad went and sewed up my hand, but I couldn't do much about the pain. Boss was real generous to me, though. Got myself a 5% discount on Zero G Brew. After the second bottle, the only pain I feel is emotional.
The only pain you feel is emotional. You sound like you need a surgeon.
Hey, Conrad's a surgeon. Well, he's a barber. That's like surgery, but for your hair.
Okay. I'll leave you be. Maybe she'll talk to you when you've only had one bottle, or preferably none. Amelia Kim, yeah, she's the one who's going to be replaced, so I should ignore her. I wasn't going to talk to you yet. Are you just trying to leave? Oh, everyone's leaving.
You read the latest report?
Only the part that said we ain't making our quotas.
If only McDevitt's folk hadn't abandoned us, Cannery could use those extra hands.
Nothing we can do about that.
Sure there is. We can have another zero G.
Be right back, guys.
Somebody's been rambling about some colony ship.
Spacer's Choice takes care of its own.
Yeah, the thing is, you don't have a clear idea of how people can see you or not. Well, let's talk to her first before we start rummaging back there. Who would drink apple juice? Amelia Kim.
I don't know you.
I'm Alicia Clark.
Amelia Kim, Spacer's Choice Beverage Dispenser. I don't know what you're about, but this here's a Spacer's Choice drinking establishment. We're all loyal, hard-working company folk here.
Should I try to pour in some charm? I don't remember how good I am at that. And what a fine establishment it is.
You really think so? That's kind of you. I've been trying to keep the floors clean. You got no idea how long it takes to scrub the tiles. Guess I misreckoned you. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to be curt. We just got some problems lately. I can get you a drink if you'd like. Gotta ask you to enjoy your beverage within the premises, though. Can't risk you bringing a drink over to those deserters. You understand.
Right. So that works. See, the thing is, I've forgotten. I've either forgotten or I've never been clear on it in the first place. when you have choices that show up, are they, you know, I know the ones you're not high enough in a rank, skill rank or something like that, you can't see it on the map, or you can see it. I think it's even a choice. You can choose to see it or not. I think mine's on to see the ones I'm not able to, you know, to do because my perception or charm or whatever is too low. But for the ones that are available, is it a chance to succeed, or are you guaranteed success of some kind? Anyway, not clear on that. What's this about deserters?
Traitors, the lot of them. Bunch of folks decided they were tired of working and went out into the wilds to fend for their own selves. Town's already struggling to make quotas, even without that band of slackwits abandoning their posts. Bunch of lazy, shiftless rung leeches. Anyway, enough about them. What can I do for you?
I want to talk to Reed. Where can I find him?
Do you now? And what makes you think Mr. Thompson wants to talk to you? He's a busy man. You want to talk to Mr. Thompson, try ignoring your duties. He'll summon you up to that great big tower atop the cannery, and you'll get yourself a proper dressing down.
Well, I don't have any duties. But you say that like it's a good thing.
It is a good thing. If you're not pulling your weight, you don't deserve to live here. Simple as that.
Well, there's something else I wanted to ask you.
Go ahead.
So what's your story?
I don't see how that's any of your business.
Persuade 31. Yeah, so there's my answer. I have shown the locked off options. So I cannot choose that. Yeah, there's no need to be rude.
And there's no need for you to pry either.
What if I told you I just got shot into space by a crazy scientist?
Ugh, is this the start of a joke? If you want me to laugh at your jokes, it's a 3-drink minimum.
I wish it was a joke. Honestly, I don't even know where I am.
Most folk forget where they're standing after a few drinks. Seems to me you've got a head start. Anyhow, whatever happens outside the walls is not my business. Only deserters and marauders wander out there, and I cannot tell you which I revile more.
Oh my.
My world is these four walls, that door, and a row of mugs that need cleaning.
It almost sounds like you're afraid to go outside.
Let me make something clear. Spacer's choice has been real good to me. The town's been real good to me. I start gallivanting around outside the walls, poking around in places I shouldn't be, learning things I've got no right to know. People will talk. Won't ever catch me asking about the world outside. Else the town's gonna say Amelia's gone soft. That Amelia's pondering desertion. I don't want that.
I think it's a mistake, though. Living your life on everyone else's terms.
There you go with that thinking again. Didn't anyone ever tell you it's dangerous? I've said enough. People come here to drink their problems away. If they wanted to face their problems, they'd go see our vicar. Oh, I almost forgot. I'm contractually obligated to recite company slogans to any visitors.
Oh.
We'll get you mostly drunk at half the price. Spacer's choice.
I'll have a drink.
Coming right up.
What do we have? 2-hour energy brew. Trip teas. Plain and pure water. Dehydrated water. And 0G brew. So wait a second. Only one of these drinks contains alcohol.
Plague got you feeling woozy? Get yourself boozy with Spacer's Choice.
Oh, brother.
Go ahead.
I've been asking around. No one seems to know anything about the Hope.
The Hope? No? I've never mixed a drink by that name. I could get you a rum and something if you like. Wait, no, never mind. We're all out of something.
I'm not talking about a drink. I'm from the Hope myself.
You feeling a bit flushed? Look, why don't you go set yourself down in the corner before you get all tangle-footed?
Not drunk. Just want to know if anybody else made it off the Hope.
Then pretend you're drunk. Sober folk don't talk the way you are. Not unless they're looking for a trip to Tartarus. The Hope's folklore, all right?
Tartarus?
60-70-year-old folklore by now. The board don't approve of spreading seditious rumors and falsehoods. You're inviting trouble talking that way, and I don't want a part of it.
You sound scared.
Look, either shut your gob or stick a drink in it. We're done talking about this.
Never mind. Just a bathroom. So I need 4 to get through. We got stuff back here. Shave and a haircut, 2 bits. Another 8. Weapon parts. We got some weapons around these here parts. Patients. Is it her? This her quarters? If so, sorry, lady.
If you're falling sick, I don't want you near me.
Don't worry. I wouldn't do that to you.
Somebody's been rambling about some colony shit.
I don't have time for this.
Alright, guys. Alright, we still have more to explore. But for now, I'm going to call it an episode. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode, and always, seek adventure.